sitting mayor, surrendering, admitting, you know what, I was a drug protector, I'm a drug protector. They'd rather admit it for fear that they'd be shot. I mean, you know, so here is a president that is, he's unorthodox, he's honestly very unique in his own way. Could this harm him?
Well, actually, not just 91%. Kahit kami sa mga progressives, no?
Exactly.
Yes, we really support his pro-people policies, his process, industrialization, no to contractualization.
Yeah. Even Christian Monson said he believes Duterte's heart is really pro-poor.
Yes, yeah. So maybe even his intention here was foreclosure nga naman, no? Gusto niyang mawala na tong controversy. Ang sinasabi na namin kay President Duterte, actually, baliktad ang mangyayari dito. Sana kung hinayaan mo na nga, baka yun na yung unti-unti yung malilimutan siya. Pero ngayon, hindi mag-closure to current. This will fuel more, ano, more controversy and more animosity.
So, do you think the right thing to do was for President Duterte to say to the Marcoses, you know, you remain my good friends, but out of respect for the Filipino people and the history, I cannot allow something like that.
And the fact that you committed to the Philippine government that you will bury him in Ilocos, now that I know about it, sorry, hindi ko na mapapatupad itong sinabi.
Now, what can the Supreme Court do? I'm curious. Does the Supreme Court have a say in any of this?
I definitely may say that the Supreme Court can always issue a temporary restraining order.
On the burial?
Under the Constitution. Yeah, it's a controversy. You know,
will you file a case?
That's what we're studying now, actually. Uh-huh. We've been thinking on what grounds na makapunta para makakuha ng TRO. So that's on the table right now.
But you'd have to do that soon because the burial's projected to be in September.
Yes, we have to do that soon. Kasi, you know, it's not easy to file a case in the Supreme Court, no? So, that's on the table. We will study the possibility.
All right. Last words, Attorney Neri, and I want you to close with this. Someone could be watching you right now and saying, is it really that wrong? That's the point. Yeah. Somebody on TV could be saying, you know what? I voted for Senator Bongbong. He's a great guy. He did well on the BBL or something. You know, I know Governor Aimee. I think she's a governor now. And she's good in her province. She served. You understand me?
Yes.
So you already have these opinions coming in from people that have met them, have dealt with them. Or saying, you know, I know Irene Marcos, she's done a lot for arts, she's very humble. I'm just throwing you another side of a viewer's point of view.
Yes.
And then what would be the, I mean, you know, they could be asking these things. What or a young person, what is the big deal? Nako, yan ang mahirap. Yeah. Yun, sa social media, 20 years old. Ano ba to si Attorney Neri and the others? Yeah. They have, my gosh, they have not moved on. Millennials na tayo. Yun.
Actually, ang hiningi ko nga sa kanila is the same question. Ano ba naman ito? Pero sa Marcoses, you cannot move on. In-overthrow na nga kayo eh. May sinoli na nga na pera dito na ninakaw nyo eh. Tapos ngayon, you cannot move on and just say, sige na nga, ilibing na nga namin to. So, mas doon sa kanila eh. Kasi dihado ang taong bayan ng martial law. Ang taong bayan yung na-violate ng human rights, yung pera nilang nanakaw. Tapos sila pang sasabihan mong mag-move on. Diba? Parang hindi tama. Dapat dito na lang sa kabila na sila ang nang agrabyado. Kayo na kaya mag-move on. Pabayaan mabuti nga. Hindi pa kayo hinabol ng gusto-gusto eh. Diba?
Do you think everyone's forgotten about the stolen wealth?
Not everyone, but,
most,
the fact
you
is,
believe.
Kasi hindi na maalala eh. Parang, there was a 32 billion peso na binalik. Ano yun? Parang nobody's parang even asking the question. So, kanino yun, di ba?
Or the PCGG's function.
Yes, kung logical ka mag-isip, sabihin mo, they must have done something there. Bakit sila,
something wrong.
Something wrong. Kasi bakit may 32 billion sila doon sa Swiss banks. So, sa akin, the lesson here, yan ang pinaka-importante talaga. Kasi you get away with it pala eh. That's the lesson eh. Crime does pay, di ba? So, mahalaga ito, ang halaga nito sa not just sa history kundi sa current moral uprightness ng generations natin, malaking bagay yan kumpara sa, actually hindi ko maintindihan kung anong main reason ng mga Marcoses, bakit nila ini-insist na ilibing pa doon, di ba? Pero naintindihan dapat natin yung reason ng taong bayan at mga biktima, bakit sila nag-i-insist na huwag? Kasi the message will be there. And that the message is that you can declare martial law, violate human rights, steal public funds, and get away with it, and be considered a hero pala in the future.